A message of great importance. The teacher said we could look in this old box and you should see the things we found.
Wow, look at this bugle.
Oh, neat.
Say, do you think somebody wore this old army coat?
Yay, how about this hat?
And look at this funny old dress.
Hey, I've got an idea. Let's put on this old stuff and have a parade.
And Shanna, I was just thinking, I bet you could tell us something about our Liberty Bell that rang July 4th, 1776.
Yes, it is a huge 2,080-pound bell, older than our United States. It was brought from England to America. The proud bell hung in Independence Hall in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
July 4, 1776, it rang out a message of great importance. It was the news that the first American colonies were to be free and independent. A new nation was born. Here, honored and loved, it stands in America today and reminds us of our good fortune.
Let's look in this next room and see where George Washington met with Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, and other great men who wrote the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution. Excited men, women, and children gathered here to listen to the reading of these important papers.
This is a copy of the Declaration of Independence prepared by Thomas Jefferson of Virginia, a friend of George Washington. It said the 13 colonies were to be free and independent. People shouted for joy as they listened to the words of independence. The 56 signers pledged their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor to its support.
Let's sing and give thanks for the liberty and freedom we have in America.
I've heard of freedom before, but what's liberty?
Liberty is a big word, kids. It's really just another word for freedom.
Let's sing about liberty. Let's sing about liberty. It's all about you and me. It's all about being free. Let's sing about liberty. Let's spell it out. Liberty. L-I-B-E-R-T-Y. L-I-B-E-R-T-Y. L-I-B-E-R-T-Y spells.
Yes, it's all up to you and me to keep our country free and follow the laws.
Hey kids, remember when our flag had 13 stars? It was said that the General Washington drew a picture of a flag and took it to Betsy Ross, the wife of a soldier. With her scissors, Betsy Ross cut 7 long strips of red cloth and 6 long strips of white and sewed them together neatly.
In one corner, she placed a square patch of blue cloth. On the blue square, she carefully sewed 13 white stars in a circle. There was a stripe and a star for each colony. A star has been added for each new state as it came into the Union. Today, the American flag has 13 stripes, but there are 50 stars in the blue square.
The salute of our flag is the promise of loyalty to our country, which is in the heart of every true American. David Blackburn will now sing the Pledge Allegiance song.
Pledge means promise.
Allegiance.
Allegiance means to be true.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands.
Republic means government of the people.
One nation under God.
Nation means country.
Indivisible.
Indivisible means cannot be separated.
With liberty and justice for all.
Liberty means freedom. Justice means fairness.
Vid means
to be brave.
White means
to be good.
Blue means
to be true.
Be proud!
It's really great to be living in the United States of America.
Perfect, but it's pretty great.
Only there's for Maine to the 50th.
perfect, but it's pretty great. All the way clear down from Maine to the 50th state.
In 1620, the little ship Mayflower came to America. The pilgrims on board wrote a paper called the Mayflower Compact. This paper said laws would be made everyone should obey. They started a colony at Plymouth, Massachusetts. The pilgrims gave us Thanksgiving. After they had gathered in their first harvest, they invited the Indians to come and celebrate with them. Together they feasted on corn, pumpkins, wild turkey, and deer. The feast lasted 3 days, for their hearts were full of thankfulness.
Hey kids, what are we thankful for in third grade?
I'm thankful for Thanksgiving and for the good health of my friends and family. Also for the people who made America a free country, plus all the schools and teachers that they teach us to learn with pride. I'm also thankful for the parents. If we didn't have parents, us kids wouldn't be able to see the sights of America.
I'm thankful that the people of long ago gave their lives for a big, nice country. I'm glad that now we do have that country and it's named America. I'm glad that there aren't too many wars. Lots of people fought and many of them died. They were fighting for the freedom of their country, and they got it. I'm thankful that they set aside this day to give thanks. It's called Thanksgiving.
Sound of America, too.
Hello.
Who knows who America was named after?
I do. We studied about it in history. It was Marigold Vespucci.
Well, that's close. It was Amerigo Vespucci, an Italian-Spanish explorer.
Boy, good thing they didn't name this country after his left.
Mr. President, I liked our speech on TV. It was a good speech about us working together and about America. I liked the way you told about your life. I also like the parade. You are going to be living in the White House now, and you are going to be working hard to be the United States President. Sincerely, Darren Trim.
American's Creed. I believe in the United States of America as a government of the people, by the people, for the people, whose just powers are derived from the consent of the governed, a democracy and a republic, a sovereign nation of many sovereign states, a perfect union, one and inseparable, established upon those principles of freedom, equality, justice, and humanity for which American patriots sacrificed their lives and fortunes. I therefore believe it is my duty to my country to love it, to support its constitution, to obey its laws, to respect its flag, and to defend it against all enemies.
Three cheers for the red, white, and blue. For the red is the blood of our brothers, the white is the light of the star that has led us to where we are. The blue is the hue of the sky, where on high the Almighty falls never. Our banner for 200 years, O pioneers, is to the stars and stripes forever.